Well, I look at that, and there's one thing it needs. That huge, huge window, front window, just looks out of shape. Don't look right. It needs a sun visor. Now, it's got a little visor here on the back, and that looks all right, I guess. It needs a visor on the front. Well, nobody makes a visor for anything like this, any of that shape at all. So it looks like I gotta find something to make my own. So I'll take you around back. Was gonna do it out of chicken wire. Wendy came up with the idea. She says, "You got that old camper top for the El Camino. It's all smashed. There it is. The ice slid off the roof. I didn't think it'd come this far. And landed on it and smashed it all to pieces. Can it be fixed? Sure, it can be fixed. Nothing can't be fixed. But do I want a topper for the El Camino? No. Not really. So I am going to cut the front half off of that, and I'm going to straighten it back up the way I want it, refiberglass it, and make a sun visor. So that's what we're doing. I guess I need a bigger wheel to get down deeper to do two layers there. I go get a bigger wheel. There it is. There, we got that off. So we have a new visor. At least the beginnings of one. Well, there it is. Put a little weight on it to let it flatten out. It's been sitting for 30 years bent, so we'll have to give it some time to flatten and then put some, clip it up, get it trimmed to what we think is right, what we want, and then put some bracing and fiberglass it, and we'll have a sun visor for the Ford Focus. Well, here we are. We are sanding all this because that's lacquer paint, and it poses a problem putting fiberglass on that, trying to expect it to stick. We got the underside done as well. Get it all cleaned up and start making a frame for it. Thank you. Now, the thing to remember is I don't have any pattern other than that sweep. It isn't the right width. You know, it'll probably have to be sectioned, cut in half, piece taken out, put back together again. I'm just starting with a basic shape, and now I got to figure out how to transfer that basic shape into an actual frame that'll bolt to the car and do what we need done. You'll notice that this is pretty flexible. At 90 miles an hour, that'll break. It's not strong enough. But you'll notice there's a lip here. Little wave. Just enough room to put a nice 3/8 rod. Right across there. Bend it. Stay with the sweep down to the A-pillar. Weld it to the A-pillar. There'll be a flat bar probably on the A-pillar. On the right angle. Then I'll probably use a piece of 1/2-inch flat bar to come up from there around here, because I haven't got as much room. There's a tip here as well. I'll lay that across there. I'll put a couple of grid patterns in. That'll stiffen that whole thing up into one piece. And this steel will all be bolted right to the A-pillars. There has to be a gap behind this to let the air that's caught underneath it get out over the roof. All those things have to be taken into consideration. And we're just starting. You'll notice that the disc grinder, it leaves divots and stuff. All I wanted off was the old finish. This is gel coat, and then the fiberglass below that. It's broken here. This all has to be repaired, glued back together. Not glued, fiberglass back together. And then when this rod's in here, that rod's all going to be buried right in fiberglass. The strap up here, the cross rods, all has to be buried in fiberglass. So this will be quite thick. It'll be about 1/2-inch thick when it's all done. But it'll be strong. Also have to consider, I have to get it at the right angle to the windshield. Otherwise, it'll either be catching wind or it'll be deflecting wind down. I'd rather have it deflected down a little bit than catch it. But you want it just not right level, just down, just maybe at 2 degrees, so that it cuts into the wind. So this is just the beginning. I got nothing done yet. All I got is a chunk of fiberglass. But it's a good start. There's no plans for this. There's no, nobody telling me what to do or how to do it. It's just a matter of testing it on the car, roughing it in. Just keep building until you get what you want. Then hopefully it'll come out looking real, sneaky. That's the old word we used to use. A car looks sneaky. You get that hood down, you know, the windshield down, the nose up a little bit. Anyways, we'll see how it all turns out in the end. Bye for now.